pretty big head.
You have a pretty big head.
Hey, Wets. So.
I got a wig, it's cute. When I first put this on, I felt like I got strong the mom for Wizards of Waverly Place vibes. Pretty late, Liam. It's getting pretty laid.
What?
I said it's getting pretty laid.
Late?
Laid! My hair! Never mind.
I don't even know what that means.
You ever heard somebody say it's late? Their hair's laid?
Doesn't look like Aya. I'm talking to the wrong person.
Okay. Rin knows, right, Rin? Rin, my hair's laid, right? She said yes. Rin's a cat. Just to match my skin color song. I'm such a wig pro, like, come to me for your wig tips. I got you. I didn't really even take you like a before picture or like show any befores, so I can't even do a comparison. I think that looks good. I always check Snapchat to see if my hair looks good.
Is that the ultimate test?
Yeah, it looks good on Snapchat.
At least you're cute. My girlfriend's so cute.
Thank you.
Thank you. What is that, like, little razor thing?
It's an eyebrow razor, but I'm using it to cut my hair. I'm also not good at being cute. The side doesn't want to stay down, but like that's okay because I really don't care. And also I didn't do this side because it's going to be down anyways and I don't want gel all in my hair. I have lots of hairs right there. I don't want jello ripping them out.
I suck at baby hair. I suck so much. It's okay. Still looks cute.
Ew, that's... It's been a long time, I know, okay? There will be an update video, explanation video coming when I have time to sit down and just like ramble on for like hours. Until then, I'm doing a hair video about this wig because I got a lot of questions on Snapchat about it. And my last one, but I don't have that one on me and I don't like that one as much. And it was my first wig, so I didn't really make a video about that one. But if you guys still want one, I can do one. But anyways, I'm home to film this and like I came all the way home. Brought my camera, bought all my stuff, did everything, you know, but I forgot to even check if my battery was charged. And I forgot my battery charger, so I'm filming off my phone. And on top of that, I let my sister borrow my tripod and take it back to college with her, so now I just have this like wobbly pile of boxes. I didn't glue the wig down because I'm gonna be taking it off to wash my hair, my real hair underneath it, as soon as I'm done with this, so I didn't really glue it down. I filmed a video at Liam's with me styling this wig, but I didn't really show it from scratch, like a before and after. I just started wearing wigs. So like, I literally don't know what I'm doing. I just watch a bunch of YouTube videos on how to style wigs and I try to mimic them. And I think I did a pretty good job. It looked cute in the video, in the other clips. You guys will see. It looked cute. So I think I did a kind of good job. But I didn't really go into detail about this wig. So that's why I'm here filming this so I can tell you guys about it. And by the way, this video is not sponsored. I'm just making it because a lot of people were asking me about it on Snapchat. The main question I've been getting about this wig is where did I get it from? I got it from a website called Diva Trust. And like I said, I just started wearing wigs, so I wasn't really sure where I wanted to get. Like, I wanted to get like a cheap straight wig just because that last one I got was really curly. And I don't know. I wanted to try something different, but I'm not really a curly hair person. So I got bored of it really fast. Like I just got over it. So I just wanted to get like a cheap straight wig because that last curly one was like, I paid like over $100 for that and I wasn't trying to pay another $100 on another wig. So I went to YouTube just looking up like inexpensive wigs. I just typed in inexpensive lace front wigs. And I just was watching a bunch of different YouTube videos, different wigs until I found one that I liked. With the link to a website that like seemed like a good site. And I found Diva Trust and I found this straight hair wig called Catherine. And then I looked that up on YouTube, like the specific like wig and the name and the web from this website. I looked it up and it looked pretty good. So I ordered me one and I love it. It was only like $40-something. And honestly, to me, it looks more natural than the one that I paid over $100 for. This is what the website looks like. And the blonde one, that's Catherine. That's the one I have on now. And I got it in a color 2, which is like a dark brown because they were out of 1B, which is what I would usually get. That's pretty much how the wig looked when I got it, kind of. just in this color, and I have straightened it. So yeah, the wig is on this website for $42.95, which that's how much I paid for it. It's really cheap, and you can straighten it. It is a mix of human and synthetic hair, so you know, it tangles a lot, but like, it's also really easy to untangle. You just brush it from the ends. You can even like untangle it with your fingers. I wrote down notes. Where's my book? Because I knew I was gonna forget a lot of stuff. Leave it up to me to lose my notes. I wrote down notes so I wouldn't forget what to talk about in this video, and I freaking lost them. So, okay, that's such a me thing. That's a Shalay thing. Like, that's... I'm just gonna try my best to remember some points, key points to talk about, and if you guys have any questions, just ask me in the comments and I'll reply. So yeah, this wig comes in a bunch of different colors, from blonde to jet black to off black to red to different shades of brown. The clips of me styling it is like before I straightened it, so that's how it pretty much looked out the box. Besides the fact that I plucked it off camera and I razored it a lot off camera. The reason I didn't show like me styling it like start to finish straight out the box was because I wasn't sure if I even wanted to make a video about it, because like I said, I'm super new to wigs and I don't know what I'm doing. Basically, I'm just kind of like just trying. I'm pretty much just doing like a trial run, because I'm not sure like if what I'm gonna do is gonna look good or not. And honestly, I think I plucked it a little bit too much on this side, but I can kind of hide it, so it doesn't really matter. It's not really glued down right now, but I'm gonna show you guys how it looks. My last one that I got it from AliExpress. I just typed in 360 lace wigs and I read the reviews and I picked whatever one had like the best reviews that was in like my price range. My last wig was like over $100 and the lace was just like so noticeable, and I didn't really like, I like tried everything. I tried covering it with makeup, I tried tinting the lace. The only thing I didn't try doing was bleaching it, and because I didn't want to damage the wig. But this one, I don't know if the knots are bleached already, because it blends in with my skin tone way more than my other one. I don't know if this lace was bleached or not. But it is a 3XL Swiss lace front wig. I don't know what any of that means, to be honest. But I think Swiss lace is like softer. There's like a soft like padding underneath this that I guess that's what Swiss lace is. I don't know. I just plucked it a little bit so it didn't look too like wiggish. So like over here, I feel like it kind of plucked too much. But sometimes it looks okay and then sometimes it doesn't. I don't know. I love this hair. Sometimes I just feel like it looks too much like a wig, but literally if you go on my old videos, this is how I wore my hair a lot of the time, and I just had like clip-in extensions in, and I just kind of push it to the side. So that's why I really like this wig, because it's like how I used to wear my hair all the time. It would look a lot better if I had it glued down, but like I said, I don't want to glue it down right now. And like the lace only comes from like here to here. Like it's not a lot of lace in the front. So like if I tried to part it over here, I'll show you. I tried to part it over here, I couldn't, because you can like see the tracks. You can start to see the tracks here. There's not a lot of lace in the front, but that's okay. Like you can part it, you can do a side part on this side, you can do a side part on this side, and you can do a middle part if you wanted to. Straight out the box, the wig kind of looked really weird to me. Like, it comes with layers already in it, and for some reason to me, the layers seemed really choppy to me. Like it was like a really long piece, and then like this really short, is really short in the front. So like, I don't know, like now it looks cute. It looks cuter straightened. That's why I straightened it, because it blended better when it was straight. So that's the only thing I didn't like about it. So I did cut this hair a lot. Like I cut some from the ends just so it didn't look too long. Like, cause it was like really long in the back and then like really short in the front. Like it was just so weird. So I cut it so it wasn't too long. And then I took a razor and I kind of just razored. Like I would just take pieces, like sections of the hair like this and just razor like that. I guess I'm not sure what my goal was. Like I said, I don't know what I'm doing, but I just thought if I just like razor it, it'll look more realistic, because like real hair, all the strands isn't the same length. The razor made it look more frizzy, and I like that. I don't know, I don't like nice and neat hair. I like messy hair. So like I just took a razor and I just kind of like I made more layers, but for some reason it looked better than it did before. And also the wig just looks really thick. Like it feels thin, but when you put it on your head it looks kind of thick. I don't know, maybe it's because I have a small head, I don't know, but it looked thick. So I thought if I razored it, I could thin it out, which it kind of worked. I don't know, whatever I did, I like it now more than when I took it out the box. So I'm making this to explain, because I did a lot of stuff off camera. So the first thing I did was pluck around the hairline so it looked more natural. And then I cut it, like I said. Then I cut the end so to make the wig a little bit more shorter so that weird layers weren't super long. And then that's when I started razoring. I started razoring like to make some short parts here. So I can just pull them out, like if I was to clip it up like this, I can pull out some short bits. I like doing that. Someone's real hair would not be like, all the strands would be the same length. So that's pretty much what I was trying to do by razoring it and by cutting. I cut a lot of this hair, okay? There was a lot of hair like all over the place. And that's another thing. This hair like doesn't really shed unless you cut it. So while I was plucking it, a lot was coming out. And while I was razoring it, a lot was coming out. But that's because I was cutting it. I was removing the hair on purpose. But it doesn't really shed. Like, for a $40 wig, it does not, like, shed at all. And that's awesome. I wish I had my notes. This video would be so much more, like, put together if I didn't lose my notes. I absolutely love this wig. Like, it's super realistic for being $40. Well, in my opinion, at least. It does take a lot of work. So a lot of people were asking me where I got it from. I assumed because they wanted to get it as well. But there's a lot of work you gotta do to this hair. It doesn't come with baby hairs, so I did have to make my own, and I didn't show you guys that, but yeah, I did have to make my own baby hairs, which I'm not good at baby hairs. Like, I can cut them, but when I try to lay them, it just, I don't know, it doesn't look right. Like, I guess because I've never really been a baby hairs kind of person anyway. Like, I've never laid my baby hairs since I was a baby. My grandma used to do our hair when we were like little toddlers, and I have, this is a picture of all of us with like our baby hairs laid, and it's so cute. But as I got older, I never laid, I didn't do my baby hairs. So when I lay my baby hairs, it just looks weird to me. So I cut them because it would make the wig look more natural, because people do have baby hairs. Like, I like the fact that I have them cut, and I kind of just like, sometimes I'll just take some gel and just flatten them, like just so that they stay down and like at least they're there. But I don't try to style them anymore because I never, like, I don't like how it looks when I do it. It just doesn't look right to me. And you'll see, like, in the video where I showed me styling it, I styled my baby hairs, but I really didn't like it, so I think I pushed them out the way in that video. It's safe to straighten up from 350 to 400 degrees, which is amazing. I've been straightening on 300 degrees because I forgot, like, what the description said. Yeah, I'm really drawing a blank here. Like, I don't remember if I was gonna say anything else about this. I think I covered pretty much everything I wanted to say about this wig, though. So just be mindful, if you want to buy it, just be mindful that you'll have to do a lot of work to it. But the amazing thing is that the lace pretty much blended in with my skin tone really well before I even did anything to it. I thought I was gonna have to like tint the lace. Oh, another thing. I almost forgot. So you know how people always talk about like the flaps on the side? Like this wig, all right, this wig fits my head like perfectly. Like my last wig was a little bit big. When I first got this wig, I fell asleep on it and I woke up and it was still on. So like I took that as a great sign. Like this wig really fits to my head really well. Besides the flaps, like they kind of went over my ears, and at first I was just tucking them behind my ear, but that kind of got like a little painful, like it started to hurt after a while. So I did cut them a little bit, but I couldn't cut it too much because the combs are right here, like right there, like behind my ears. I cut off as much as I could, which was kind of like just this little, a little part here, and I just tucked the combs behind my ears. And it feels better, it hurts a little bit less, but I might go back and just cut the combs out if I can. I did a lot of work to this wig, so I'm pretty proud of how it looks. So yeah, if you're the type of person that don't mind doing work to your wigs, then I would suggest buying this wig or the wigs off Dear Trust. But if you're somebody who is lazy, which I understand, I'm lazy too, and you just want a wig that you can just kind of like throw on without having to do anything to it, then I wouldn't suggest buying this wig. But yeah, I think I said everything I had to say. It's 16 minutes now, so I'm gonna go. If I left anything out, or if you guys have any questions, let me know in the comments, and I'll reply to you as soon as possible. But until then, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more videos from me, then subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you all in the next video. Stay cool, stay good, roots.